Why I'm Fat Part 2. I should write a book. That should be my book. Anyway, the next, if you watched the last one, I'm answering some questions from chapter 1 of Bariatric Mindset Success in an attempt to figure out why I got to the weight that I did, so that I don't go back. And you can see Jackson is with me. Cosmo doesn't like Jackson, so he's in the other room. As you look at where you are, where you've been, and where you want to go in your journey, take a deep look at your patterns of behavior. What foods are your triggers? What foods are my triggers? Sugar. I remember I had a job a long, long time ago in my 20s. I worked at a call center for a car manufacturer, and they called it a customer service line. But of course, when you buy a car or a truck or whatever, you don't call up, you know, Toyota and say, "Hey, I'm so happy with my Toyota. Thanks." You know, you don't, it's just not how it works. So it is essentially a complaint line, and it was a hard job. It prepared me for what I do now, but it was a hard job. And I was struggling with my, with mental illness at the time. I struggled with mental illness for a good many years, trying to find out the balance of medication and everything that worked for me. But I remember like buying giant bags of Jujubes to keep at my desk so I would have something to eat. I wasn't hungry. And of course, like, Jujubes aren't going to fill anything. They're not going to provide you with any nutrition. But I needed candy. I needed something at my desk to get me through the day. You know, I'd go and buy a box of Timbits. And for those of you who aren't in Canada, Timbits are delicious. They're like little miniature donuts. They're fantastic. And I would buy a box of 20 and I would eat them in a day. Or, like, I remember somebody bringing in donuts. And this is to my current office, you know, within the last few years. Somebody would bring in donuts or muffins, and I would eat 2 donuts and a muffin in a day. And along with all of the other food that I had brought for myself that day, along with the breakfast and the snacks and the lunch that I packed. So, sweets, candy, desserts, not so much chocolate bars, but like a box of chocolates, like chocolate, yeah, but not a candy bar, but baked goods, oh man, and candy. So yeah, those are my trigger foods. What emotional states do you struggle with the most? When I'm depressed. So I have a good handle on my mental health these days, but I still get down. I still have days where, you know, my depression is a little stronger than my meds can accommodate, and or I get, you know, a little bit of anxiety. It still happens. I mean, it's not a perfect science. But when I was really in the midst of struggling with my mental illness, when I was really sad, I would want to eat, and I would want to eat sugar and baked goods and chocolate. And then I would go to like a hypomanic state where I'd want to spend money and I'd want to shop and I'd want to do drugs and I'd want to drink and I'd, you know, and I'd stay up. And I remember walking to Tim Hortons once in my bare feet for no reason. I wasn't stoned and I wasn't drunk, and yet I thought it was a good idea. So I did. And I bought a box of Timbits. And so both of those states usually gets me. And then celebrations. Celebrations are all around food. You know, you take somebody out for their birthday, you go out for a drink, you get a promotion, you go for steak. You know, you have birthday cake, you have anniversary cupcakes, you have baby showers. A celebration is all about food. And I have to figure out how to celebrate without food that isn't going to cost a fortune. Like, I don't want to go out and buy a wardrobe. I don't want to go out and get my hair done because it costs $300. But I need something that isn't food. When do you crave foods that are not nutritionally sound? I am an external eater. I crave foods after I see them. Typically, sometimes I'll, around that time of the month, I'll crave some chocolate, but I typically don't crave something unless somebody's talking about it, or I see an ad or a commercial or a billboard, and then it puts it in my head, and then I crave it. So commercials for food are designed for people like me. Unless, except in that time when I was really stressed working that job, when I was eating candy all the time. But I crave coffee. I feel like I should always have a cup of coffee in my hand. Not too terrible, because I drink half decaf and it's black, so it's not awful. But yeah, that's what I crave. Do you have a habit of sabotaging yourself when it comes to food or food triggers? I have a habit of, we'll start tomorrow. Or, the day's already ruined, why not? I've already had something crappy for dinner or for lunch, let's have dessert. I have that tendency. Or, I could go for a walk today, or I could go for a walk tomorrow. Oh, we'll start tomorrow. Oh, my leggings aren't clean, I can't work out today. Or, I have a headache, I really don't want to do yoga. So I have that tendency. That's how I sabotage myself. Especially the, I've already messed up today, so let's just go whole hog and start fresh tomorrow. That's a mindset that I'm slowly getting out of, but not completely. And so I still sometimes have those days where, you had chocolate for lunch. I don't know. You had a couple pieces of candy earlier today. It's already a wash day. So let's have a brownie, or let's have some ice cream. That was the last question. So, I mean, that's some information about me. That's just the first chapter. I'm sure I'll do more videos as my emotional journey proceeds. But that's where I'm at. So ask yourself these questions. Make your own videos. Write them down. I will continue to blog about, the coming chapters, and hopefully I'll learn stuff. Okay. Stay strong, my friends.